Hi everyone. Today I will make a comparison between two pens from Rami. And the first one is called Rami CP1. The second one is Rami Peel. And they are very similar pen. Let me show you. Look very similar, the design is almost the same. And let me show you first specification of this pen. For the Rami CP1, this one. The diameter of the pen is 9 millimeters. And the length of the pen is 135 millimeters CP1. And the next one, Rami Peel. The size is a little bit bigger, 11 millimeters for the diameter. And the length is a little bit longer, 138 millimeters. The weight of the two pens are very similar, 18 grams for Rami CP1 and 16 grams for Rami Peel. Okay. And let's see. The smaller one, 9 millimeters, is CP1. And the bigger one is Rami Peel. Okay. And I am going to let you see the diameter of the pen. Let's see. This one, compared to each other. 2 millimeters difference. And I compare with the pencil, a pencil. This is the size of a pencil. Let's see. Rami CP1 is a little bit bigger than a pencil. And if you look on the side, pencil, Rami CP1 and Rami Peel. See? So when I bought a Rami CP1, because I thought it's really nice and it doesn't look like a fountain pen, because it's doesn't look fat and it doesn't have the torpedo shape like other fountain pen. And I think it's cool. And but when I first hold it in my hand to write it, to write, I feel that the pen is really small compared to my hand. The pen is really small. So the feeling is like you are holding a pencil. Looks beautiful, but it's small compared to my hand. And if I don't pose it, it's going to be like this if I hold it. Okay. So right now I am going to compare Rami Peel, which is a little bit bigger, and I think for me Rami Peel is a perfect size. And I am familiar with the Rami Safari, and the feeling when I hold the Rami Peel is like I hold the Safari pen. And for outside, I will show you both of them are metallic pen. This part, the cap part, and the body of the pen are made of metal. The same with Rami Peel. It's made of metal. Metal here, the cap, and the metal here. The ending part of the end part of the both pen are made of plastic. It's not obvious in this video because the color of the pen are black, so you cannot see the difference between plastic part and the metal part here. But this is plastic. This is also plastic. And the clip of the pen, this one is made of stainless steel. This is also made of stainless steel. But this one is a solid stainless steel. If you look from the bottom, you can see that it's solid. Why this one? For the Lamy Pearl, it is a brush. Oh, sorry, it is a polished stainless steel. So it's really shiny. The clip is really shiny. But it's made of a metal sheet and therefore it to make it like this shape. And the spring load is really, really steep. And this one, also the spring load clip. And this is really round, so it's easy to slide into your shirt pocket because this part is really round. This part is I try to slide into my shirt pocket, but it usually got stuck here. But it's not a big deal. I mean, you can force it a little bit and then it will go down. And the logo for the Lamy CP1, the logo is on the clip. They engraved the word Lamy here on the clip. Why the Lamy Pearl, they painted the word Lamy here on the cap. And from outside, you can see at the top of the pen, Lamy Pearl, this is not flat. It is a little bit concave. But for Lamy CP1, this is flat. And on the bottom, this end, the same thing. This is flat. This is concave. And if you compare the size here, look from the size, they are really similar. The length of the pen when you close the cap is about 2 millimeters. The difference. Lamy Pearl is longer. And I will show you inside the structure of the pen and the converter. So if I open the cap, you can see I open the cap. And I open the cap of Lamy Pearl. You can see. Very similar, except the size. And I already measure for you, when you open the cap, the length of Lamy Pearl is about 5 millimeters longer than Lamy CP1. Okay, 5 millimeter longer. This part is made of metal. This part is also made of metal. This part are plastic. And the feet of the pen are the same. They used normal Lamy nib, and you can interchange between this nib and the other Lamy nib, except Lamy 2000, which has a special nib, smaller one. So the nib interchangeable. This part, the grip part, are plastic, look similar. Okay, so I am going to show you the structure of the converter, ink converter. Okay, you turn this, rotate this and take this off. You can see inside. This is made of brass, I think. You can see the thread. So metal feeling. Really light, but you know that it is not plastic, okay? And this is the normal Lamy converter C27, okay? And I am going to open this one, Lamy Pearl. You can see the converter. the ink converter. Okay. The difference is they use the same ink converter. The difference is for this one, Lamy CP1, you can see the whole converter. There is no plastic part to cover the any part of the converter. So if I take this off, and I can push it in, just push it in. So you can see the whole converter. Because the pen is too is very small, so this one doesn't go into the hole. Compare to this one, Lamy Pearl. You can see that this part, the plastic part, has the longer tube to cover half of the converter. So if I take the converter out, it's just tight fit. Take it out. You can see the same converter. And if I put it back in, it will go into the tube. And you place it tightly. Done. So the difference between this, the structure of these two pen is the length of the this part. This cover the converter. This doesn't cover the converter. The end, the nib of the pens are the same. But this one they use the black one. This one I got with the black with the silver one, but I changed to black. So okay. So if I close this one, you just turn it. Close it. I close this one. So the same. Very similar. When you look at this, this one is like a the same pen, but just you make it bigger. Look like the same pen, but you make it bigger. So when you don't close the cap, this one Lamy Pearl is about 5 millimeter longer. And if I keep it posed, I pose it the cap on, and I pose the cap on, it going to look like this. You can see that for the both pen will have no gap between the end of the cap and the body of the pen, no gap when closed, when you pose it. But when you take this pen out and close at the top, click, and you take this pen out and you close it, you can see that there is no gap here. Smooth, straight cylinder. But this one, you will see there is a gap. I completely close it. This is their design. So you still see the end of the cap and the end of the body. So you can see a small gap here. It's normal. This is completely closed. So this is the difference. And when you take it out, you close it, you can hear the click sound. That is really tight. And the same thing, when I take this out, Lamy Pearl, and I close, you can hear the sound click. That means it's already tight. And so this is the outside and the inside. I already show you for the writing feel, when you write it, you hold the pen like this. I tend to hold the pen longer on this part for the end of the pen touching this part of my hand, and I feel like not comfortable. It's not hurt, but it's like I think it should be longer. But if I hold a Lamy Pearl, the same length, I think this part is longer. So if you don't comfortable with the short pen, you can post it, write it post like this. So I prefer to post it when I like. And for the Lamy CP1, so if I post it, it will be like this. Both of them are comfortable. It's just my personal preference that I feel that Lamy CP1 is small compared to my hand, and I am not familiar with smaller pen. So it's like I am using a pencil. So I like the feeling of holding Lamy Pearl. I think it's more comfortable writing style for me. But it depends on you. You might like the smaller one, or you might like a big one. So it looks like this. And I don't see Lamy Pearl on the website of some country. I don't know why. It says this is new. But for Lamy CP1, you can, I think it is available all over the world. And what I heard is that the design is like in 1970s something. So this design has been Lamy style for a long time. So many people should know about it. The good thing about the smaller pen is that you can keep it in a small pocket, and it doesn't look like a fountain pen. And also you can keep in a slot of your notebook or your journal with ease, because it's really small, really small. This one is just like a normal size pen. So when you grip it or you hold it, you feel no different with the other pen. And both of them are really light, not really chunky. And the weight is really light, and the weight is really comparable. They are like 18 grams and 16 grams. So I think this is about it. Lamy CP1 and Lamy Pearl. And the size, you can see side by size. And the nib are the same. And the length, Lamy Pearl is about 5 millimeters longer when unposed. Okay, thank you everyone. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you.